going to be doing the Summertime Reading Fun Tag. It was originally by Kim S. Good, and I was tagged by JD Estrada. So, tea, of course. And this is basically a chance for me to kind of tell you a bit about my current work in progress, the book that I am working on. Funny thing that, technically I have a stack of work in progresses, but I'm gonna go with the work in progress that I've spent the most time cultivating that is the closest to publication, I hope. I hope at this time. And that is my gray moleskin here. I've actually been through several notebooks with this book, but that's okay. So, question number one. What is the working title? So the working title for this book is The Darkest Thread. Dun, dun, dun. I've even made mock book covers, especially for, like, I was going to do Camp NaNoWriMo this past. I didn't really talk much about it because what ended up happening was a friend of mine who is in her 70s wasn't feeling so well. So I ended up spending a lot of time just sitting on her porch with her having tea instead of the frenzy writing that I thought I was gonna do on The Darkest Thread. So, but I'm a big believer in these things happen in life, and it's important to spend time with the ones that you love when they need it, especially. And I mean, what are you writing for if you aren't taking that time for the human connection? That's, yeah, anyway. So that's what happened with that. We'll just, next time Camp NaNoWriMo comes around, I'll do it again. So hopefully that successfully. Working title, The Darkest Thread. Where did the idea for this novel come from? Okay, so the original idea is a pretty old idea. Maybe 4 or 5 years ago, I saw a notice on Francesca Leah Block's blog, and she was asking for submissions for the Love of Magic anthology, and I don't remember exactly what the conditions were, but she wanted to have a story that showed how love conquers all and using magic somehow. So that was the original idea, was given to me. It was like a writing prompt, as it were. And I hadn't, I love Francesca Leah Block. So I saw that opportunity and I was like, I have to come up with something. So I sat down, and then the funny thing was, the submission guide, it said that it was about to be closed. So I didn't have very much time to do this. So I wrote it really fast, and I submitted it. And that was the original seed for The Darkest Thread. That was accepted, by the way. It was published, that original story. So if you want to see the original idea for where this came from, it's that. What genre is your work in progress? It is fantasy. Yes, fantasy. Number four, which actors would you choose to play in the movie edition of your book? So this was a bit hard because I don't know a lot of, I don't think about actors and actresses in terms of that. A lot of people plan out, like, this is what I want, the dream movie, but I haven't done that. So my main guy is named Ab, and he is a big demon, and he's described as having a lot of scars. He is not described as being very attractive, which is funny, because I know that a lot of people find this man very attractive, but it's a movie role, right? So I'm sure that they put schmuckus on him and give him a bunch of fake scars and make him look pretty rough, but I need him to be a big hulking man because he's a demon. He's this huge, described as very, very tall, very muscular, and scarred up, and just looks a mess. So I picked the guy who played Khal Drogo because that guy was massive and he looked pretty rough at times, but I know that, I'm sorry. In my book, I said he's ugly, but you know how Hollywood is. Hollywood doesn't want to keep ugly characters. They want everybody to be beautiful, so Jason Momoa. Okay, so for my heroine, that girl is her working title name, her is Layla, and she is an immortal fate. So like the Greek fates who did the spinning of the thread of life, and then the measuring of the thread of life, and then the cutting of the thread of life. So my main girl is the girl who is the cutter of the thread of life. And so that's hard. She is a very complicated, emotional person, but I think in my mind, she's very subtle with her emotions because she's trying to be very in control all the time. So I picked Chloe Grace Moretz because she's good at conveying subtleties. Pop a dark wig on her because my character is described as having dark hair. So just pop a dark wig on her. She'll be fine. Okay. Number five, write a one-sentence synopsis. All right, so after the shears used to cut the thread of life are stolen, Layla vows to get them back, but can she do it before the balance of power shifts to the golden god Kressel, who demands her death to spare her sisters? Dun, dun, dun. Okay, so what are your publishing plans for this book? So I plan on publishing it, and it remains to be seen whether it is published by a company or if I self-publish it. I'm open to having a publishing company publish it, but I'm also open to self-publishing it, so I'm not, I'm not there yet. When I finish it, I will submit it, and then we'll see. But yeah, I definitely plan on it being published, but to who, by who, I don't know. How long did it take you to write the first draft? Funny. Okay, so it started out, this story, The Darkest Ride, started by me writing a short story, and it's been through several different companies that I've talked to about it and been through different changes. So probably because I was trying to write to what I thought other people wanted, it was taking me a bit longer than normal. So I think it's taken probably the past year I've spent on it, a good solid year, I would say, writing that draft. Well, I wrote it as a novella, and then in that year I wrote it as a novella, and then I started expanding it to a novel. And now I'm back going through that and then changing it to what I want, and then, that's pretty normal, so that's okay. So about a year for the first draft for that one, I would say, but that's two drafts really. I don't know, because I wrote there was a novella, and then that was complete. It was done. I probably should have just said to hell with it and moved on with my life, but no, I had to expand it. So yeah. So how long did it take to write the novella? Probably a couple months. But anyway, it's been a saga. Number eight. What other books would you compare the story to? I would compare it to books by Neil Gaiman, probably. Or to Philip Pullman, his Dark Materials. That is lofty comparisons, so we'll see. Who or what inspired you to write this book? That's very similar to the where did your idea for this novel come from. So I guess that Francesca Leo Block originally inspired me with The World, and then another writing contest for the novella inspired me to turn that into a novella. And then my own love of mythology and Greek myths, and then comparative religions and history, Machiavelli. There's so many things that have inspired me. Dante. There's all of these ingredients that have inspired me to write the book. I think also the idea that you need to forgive everybody who has wronged you is a theme there, where I totally disagree with that. I don't think that you do need to forgive everybody, especially if they haven't changed what they did to cause the original hurt. And it depends on the level, so that's going to be addressed. So I don't know. a lot of ingredients are into that pot. What else about this book might pique a reader's interest? Swords, dragons, going to the underworld, the Borgias. Let's see, what else is in there? Blood magic. There's a lot of humor in it as well. Very wry humor, I would say. Not slapstick, but you know, very dry, unease humor, I guess. Yes. Dark matter. Physics. I try to include all kinds of weird things, weird random things. Okay, so that is that tag. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that I will be able to tell you that it is done and being published soon, but you never know, these things can take time, and perhaps maybe one of these babies will get finished first. That's really what happened before with the Weightless one, my most recent book that got finished. I actually was writing this one and then I finished that first, so who knows. But anyway, I will finish my tea. So I hope that you have tea too, and I'll talk to you next time.